So are you looking to edit footage on Windows 10? You're looking for a good editing software to use, but you don't want to spend any real money. Well, there's some good free options out there. In fact, we did a lot of research. How many tools did we look at?
15.
15 tools. 15. And we found how many of the best?
Three.
The best of the best. So if you want to hear what those are, stick around. All right, so we're talking about free video editing software on Windows 10, right?
I like free.
Everybody likes free. So we found three of the best of the best.
Yes.
Of the best.
Of the best.
They're out there. Just real quick, what are those ones that you found?
Photo. It actually edits videos.
Oh, okay.
Made by Windows, built into Windows 10.
Handy.
OpenShot and Hitfilm Express.
Hitfilm Express. Cool. So those are the ones you picked that you really liked, you thought were the best. Why didn't you pick some of the other ones? Was there any particular criteria you were kind of using to help?
So it really came down to feature set, what it included, the abilities it had, along with ease of use.
Ah.
So, and quick of picking up. Because I'm assuming a lot of folks out there, if they're looking for free, they're probably not doing a lot of editing, have done it before. So it's a first time. So I was trying to find something that's very simple. Mm. There were several that were close, and some could be debatable, but this is what I felt were the best and simplest to use.
Very cool. Awesome. So let's dive into the first one. What was the first one?
Yes.
Really liked?
Windows Movie Maker does not exist.
Oh, it's gone.
It's gone.
Okay.
Not on Windows 10. No longer exists.
Interesting.
So instead, they have the ability to edit videos within this app called Photos.
Okay.
So if you search on your Windows computer, it'll be there, and there's a tab for videos.
Interesting.
And they've redone the interface so it doesn't feel like a normal video editor.
Okay.
So if you've never edited videos before, it actually may be easier.
All right.
So if you just need really simple ability to, I just need to add this video to this video and trim them up, and then export that, it can do that.
Very cool.
And has some fun twerks or interesting feature sets where it can add kind of like AR effects like Snapchat. Mm. I put a flame on my head and it tracked my head.
Okay.
So I'd be like, ooh, my head's on fire.
Cool.
Some fun things.
So maybe like Instagram stories kind of thing.
Exactly. You want some fun. You put some text on there. Has some nice features there. So really simple. That's where I would start. The second one is OpenShot. And this one is a little bit more features and is like a normal video editor.
Okay.
A normal video timeline, a browser. And when the first time you open it up, it has a tutorial that walks you through, explains what each of the windows are for and the different feature sets. So it's helpful for those who've never edited before. It'll walk you through helping you learn what the interface is like.
Very cool.
And it has some decent transitions. Some of them are a little weird, so don't go crazy.
Okay.
If you're making your business videos, don't go crazy. And it definitely has more features than just the built-in photo app.
Very cool. And what was that last one?
Hitfilm Express.
Ah, so sounds exciting.
Yeah, Hitfilm. Yeah, I want to make a film. And really, if you do want to have a lot more effects, whether it's visual effects or digital effects or stuff in the videos, the previous two will take you just a little bit there, but this one will take you all the way.
Ah.
It's probably the most comparable free platform out there to the big boys, the paid options.
Right.
And it's free.
Ish. Oh.
So when you download it, it asks you to share to your network that you just downloaded it. So they're asking you to pay by sharing it to your network. So it's basically free, but not completely. And there's a lot of extensions and plugins and add-ons that you can buy to increase the libraries of effects that you can pull from and different features like that.
Okay.
But they have a decent built-in set as well. So if you want something that's very robust, is most comparable to the big boy paid options of editors out there, and expandable, then Hitfilm is great. Hitfilm Express, they do have a Hitfilm Pro that's paid. So Hitfilm Express is the one we're talking about. OpenShot be the next one. If you need a decent feature set, you're going to be editing videos on a regular basis, and you need still a free option, it's open source option, then OpenShot is good. And it's just really basic, let me just trim and put some stuff together. Windows Photo app, which can do video as well, is your option.
All right, so those were the free ones.
Yep.
Do you find any ones that are like paid that people might be interested in?
Oh yeah, there's paid ones for sure.
Ah.
The two ones that I'd probably recommend though for Windows is in the Adobe Creative Cloud.
Ah, series. Yes.
So
Creative Cloud.
Adobe Premiere is probably the most common one used in the industry.
Yeah.
And it's both for Mac and PC, Windows 10. and has huge, robust feature set and integrates so nicely with the rest of the Creative Cloud ecosystem.
Yeah.
Photoshop and Lightroom and InDesign, After Effects.
Yeah.
And all of it comes in into here. So if you have a team you're working with, it makes sense to be able to use this.
Yeah.
But the learning curve is really steep. So if you've never done editing before, you're going to have to invest a lot of time because there's
videos,
a lot of videos.
Because
there's like within a tab, within a window, within this, you can find all your features.
Yeah.
But they did just last year come out with Adobe
Premiere Rush, right?
Premiere Rush. Very simplified version, similar to Final Cut 10, which you love.
Yes.
but that's only on Mac. So if you're on a PC, it can get you some of a feature set that they took inspiration from Final Cut 10.
Of course.
So it's great for content creators. If you need to quickly create something and get it online, share it directly to your social channel, that is a good option to look at, both within the Creative Cloud. So if your company's already paying for the Adobe Creative Cloud, you can look at these two options.
Awesome. Well, there you have it. There's some of the best free and paid editing software tools for Windows 10. If we miss one that you really like and use on a regular basis, please share a comment below and tell us why you like it and why we should have included it. You can continue the conversation on Facebook with us on the Business Video Community. It's a place to connect with video marketers and video producers and talk about all things business video.
Business video.
Till next time, I'm Evan.
And I'm Alex. Bye, guys.
Later.